So today we are going to be taking a look at the different FHIR paradigms that are available and how different people have used them and what we can really learn from them. So FHIR, apart from being a data definition, so they define what resources are and what you can capture, what you cannot. It's also a mechanism for actually transmitting this data. So people have different variations of this exact same thing, and that's what these different FHIR paradigms are. So now let's take a look at the FHIR website and see what different definitions they actually have. So first we have the REST paradigm, right? So this is just calling a server and making a GET request, making a PUT request, searching on top of the FHIR server. And you have a centralized FHIR server, and then you are able to communicate with that and you get all the information. So that's what we've mostly been covering in this channel, and that is the that's also the implementation that the US CORE profile has done. So if you take a look at the US CORE FHIR profile, they define a list of different search parameters that need to be implemented for different resources. And that's about it. Like, if you have these search parameters and if you follow the same format of these resources, you can call yourself compliant with FHIR if you are from the US. And that's because they use the FHIR REST paradigm. So that's what the FHIR REST paradigm is. Now, apart from this, there are also three other paradigms mentioned here. There is also a fourth paradigm that people usually talk about called the storage paradigm, but I don't want to get into that right now. So let's talk about documents. So the document paradigm is actually it's the one that's been implemented in India with the ABDM FHIR implementation guide. And in fact, if this takes off, it's going to be the most ubiquitous implementation of FHIR because of how populous India is, and it's going to cover like a million patients easily. So this paradigm, again, they use the document exchange paradigm, and I can show you how this looks like. So let's take a look at the implementation guide on ABDM. So what they have is they have a bunch of these clinical artifacts. Okay, so you can send, you cannot just send any resource. And again, it's not an API that you even talk to. We'll come to this later, but what they actually do is there are these well-defined clinical artifacts. So for example, let's take diagnostic report record. I already have it opened here. It'll just be a bundle and it'll be of type document, and underneath that, it'll have all of the data related to this bundle. So this will have all of the structured information as well as the unstructured PDF information right here in one single bundle. But this bundle is, again, it's a document bundle, and you can transmit this to any party through any way you like. So FHIR does not enforce anything on how the document is actually carried over to another point. So it just defines that, hey, you can you have this paradigm called the document exchange paradigm, and you define a document, we don't really care how you send this. So you can send this over email, you can send this by just putting it in a pen drive and just handing it to someone, but the way ABDM has implemented this is using its own network APIs. So ABDM has its own network, and you need to encrypt this data and then send it over the network, and another party can get it over this same network. And these network APIs need not be FHIR, okay? So that's how ABDM has implemented the document paradigm of FHIR. And up next, let's take a look at the third paradigm, which is the messaging paradigm. So the messaging paradigm, again, HL7 is coming from a messaging background mostly. HL7 V2 was mostly messaging, and HL7 V3, which is technically a variant of it which survived, is CCDA. So that's the document paradigm in a sense, and people usually transferred these documents over FTP or some sort of file transfer mechanisms. Messaging has always been ubiquitous with HL7 V2. So that paradigm still exists with FHIR, and people do use it actually. So today, one of the major implementations of the messaging FHIR paradigm is this protocol in Saudi Arabia called Nphies. So there is a PDF explaining how this whole thing works along with the implementation guide. So they actually have their implementation guide as an Excel sheet. This is the implementation guide, and they have all of the different resources. But the major thing here is they have something called the message header. So you need to send it as a bundle, again, like a message bundle. And they've defined different entities that you can send in one message bundle. We've actually been working on this. So you just have like a message URL, like process message, and you send them a FHIR bundle, very similar to how you would send a document. But again, this has a header message and you send a specific message header along with this bundle. And again, the type would be of message. So here the response is also a message. So you send a message, they send a message back, and that's how the messaging paradigm works. And again, here nobody is really telling, like FHIR is not defining anything about this process message API, although I think this can be considered a proper FHIR operation definition that they have implemented. So yeah, like you have the messaging paradigm as well, and the Saudi Arabian implementation of FHIR for insurance claim settlement uses this heavily. And apart from this, there is actually another paradigm of FHIR that is coming up and people talk about it a lot. So that is the storage paradigm of FHIR. So I wouldn't really consider it a paradigm. It's just like an implementation choice. So people, so when we talk about the REST API, you could either just have your data in your own format in a Postgres database or in a MongoDB database, and then you can convert that into a REST API response when you get the call, right? So what this means is usually people write a facade on top of their existing database, and that's what the REST API usually means. The storage paradigm is you natively store everything in your system as a FHIR document, not a document, as a FHIR resource. You natively store everything as a FHIR resource, and you offer the full spectrum of the FHIR API as your REST API, right? So this usually comes in when people use a managed FHIR service like a Google FHIR API or Microsoft Azure FHIR or Health Samurai, and people use this FHIR server to store all of their documents. So that, not documents, the resources, all of their internal resources are natively stored as FHIR documents. So that's the other paradigm. So hopefully this video was useful, and again, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. So I've actually been moving around a lot, and right now I've just come down to Bangalore, and I've been here for a bit, and so I haven't been able to make a lot of videos. So yeah, again, like thanks a lot for the support, and I think a lot of you have subscribed to my channel very recently, and I definitely want to give you value and give any knowledge that I have through videos and written content. So if you have any suggestions for something you would like to know about, please let me know in the comments below. And again, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.